Hello, this is the show called Let's Get Digital. This is the show brought to you by Digital Seniors here in the Wairarapa. And just to let you know, if you have any problems with your digital devices and you are a senior, please call our number. It's 0800-373-646. And with us today, we have Fran Reardon, and she's from Age Concern. Hello, Fran. Could you introduce yourself and tell us a little bit about yourself and what you do with Age Concern?
Oh, good afternoon, everyone. Thanks, Roger, for inviting me to speak on with you on the show. I work for Age Concern. I have done now for nearly 7 years. Some of you will know Age Concern as WHOOPS. Originally, it was called WHOOPS, which stood for an older person, Wairarapa's older person's services, and then it became incorporated in Age Concern about 7 or 8 years ago. My role at Age Concern is I'm the accredited visiting coordinator, and I'm one of three people that work out. We have our different roles. We have a social worker called Anne, and we have a health promotion person called Kayla. So we work as a team, but I'm particularly out there to help against and connect people, prevention of loneliness and social isolation and loneliness. So my role is I get visitors for people, social visitors, and it's an amazing thing to do. We wouldn't have a service without our volunteers. So we get referrals from all sorts of people, or people can self-referral, that want to have a friend, a social friend. They're confidential. They don't replace your family, but they're a really nice. It's nice to have a visitor that you can have a talk to, and you find that you have things in common with lots of people. Everyone has their own story. They have lots to offer, and so my role basically is to match the person up with a visitor that I think they'll have things in common with. Some of my visitors have been doing the role for about, well, one lady's been doing it over 26 years, so that's pretty amazing. My oldest volunteer visitor is 91, and my youngest volunteer visitor is in her early 30s, so it's quite a big range. Well, no, we have another young woman in her mid-20s. So lots of people do it. You know, they just enjoy meeting new people.
How long has this organization been around in one form or another? Because you mentioned someone has been doing it for over 20 years.
Yes, well, it was. The actual visiting service throughout New Zealand has been going for over 28 years.
I see.
So it started a long, long time ago. And starting when WHOOPS, the original mention about WHOOPS, picked it up, and then they became incorporated to Age Concern, so then the visiting service came under the guise of Age Concern.
And how long have you been working with Age Concern then?
Over 7 years.
Over 7 years,
yeah.
Very good.
So.
Now, we've been trying to coordinate Age Concern with Digital Seniors, and in fact, just yesterday, I was at one of our learning hubs in Carterton, and the lady came in, and she had a little form ready to register, and I said, where did you get that from? And she said, it was from Age Concern. They told me I should come over and visit with you folks, and she had some issues with her PC and setting some things up on it, and she was very, very thankful for us being there, and we do appreciate the referrals coming from Age Concern. I mean, we're all volunteers at Digital Seniors anyway. So, and just as a reminder to people, as I'm mentioning it, that we do have our learning hubs in various different places. We meet in Masterton, and that's usually on a Wednesday from 10 until noon at the library. In Carterton, we're 9:30 to 11:30 at the Carterton Fire Station on a Tuesday. Greytown, also on Tuesday, we're in the fire station there as well, and that's from 1:30 to 3:30. And then Featherston is Thursday from 1:30 to 3:30. And Martinborough, we have it from 9:30 to 11:30 on Thursday mornings. So right now, what I'm going to do is just take a quick little break, little music break, and we'll be back in just a few minutes. Okay, we're back with Let's Get Digital, the show brought to you by Digital Seniors here in the Wairarapa. And with me today is Fran Reardon, and she is from Age Concern. And so, Fran, during this break here, we were talking about the fact that there is a great need for somebody to come over sometimes and actually show you how to use your phone or how to use your tablet or your PC. Have you had a lot of people calling up Age Concern about that?
No, not so much. But when people do ring us, we do refer them or come and see, refer them on to your service. I think it's a fantastic service. And in fact, I could have done with it the other day when I've got my new phone for work. I'm trying to find all its little funny little quirks because it's a different device. So it's not only seniors. Lots of people have trouble with the new device, and it's you know, they're all different. But definitely, if we have often people get a gift from their family. It can be a notebook or a phone, and with no instructions, and it's handed to them, and you go and use it. So it's fantastic having a service, someone coached through using a new device. And that's what people want. They don't want to be talked to, they just want to be someone sit next to them and get them to use it. And the more, I guess, they use it, the easier it becomes. Yeah,
absolutely. I found that the problem is lots of young people have grown up with these devices, so they know, and they're just not afraid about touching buttons and doing any kind of thing on there or downloading whatever. They just, you know, fearless. But as you get older, you just realize, ooh, you could be doing something wrong here. You may not break the phone, but you might be doing something that you lose a file or something else happens, or you interrupt the telephone call by mistake or whatever. And, you know, we try to help people as much as we can, but it can be difficult because every device can be different. Every device may be a different manufacturer than what we're used to. You've got your iPhones, and you've got your Samsung phones, and you got the Huawei phones, and they're all a little bit different from each other. However, the same principle applies. There are certain buttons to make a phone call, and there are certain buttons you can use for sending text messages, and that's where we try to help seniors with that. And one of the funny things is that we try to tell them that there are certain abbreviations used in text messages that they haven't understood. One example was somebody was reporting on the fact to their daughter, "Oh, your Uncle Harry just died," and they wrote LOL, and the daughter wrote back, "Well, why are you laughing about it? I thought that meant lots of love." No, it means laugh out loud. So sometimes you can get into a little bit of a tricky situation with that. So what's been your experience with some of the seniors who have called up Age Concern?
Well, most of it's been positive. I mean, I have got clients who are elderly who send me, still email me, which is great. You know, they've sort of stuck with it. We have had our visitors actually use those devices and will sit, particularly with them, someone who cannot see or having difficulty hearing and talking to their loved ones on the phone overseas. So there's a bit of emailing going on, and we would really like them to sort of bring it up to things like Zoom or FaceTime, and some of them are looking at that. But mainly it's people who have got a device and they're worried about being scammed as well with their phones, because some of there's some phone scams and things. So they're a little bit terrified of that, and they just want to be reassured that they are using it right, or they haven't given away their details and things like that. So that's another worry, isn't it, with
yes.
that?
Yeah. Is there a particular scam that you know of going around right now that they should be aware of?
Look, there's always a scam going around. Yes. I'm not up with that. There's still that overseas number that comes. You get a phone call, it will ring two or three times, and then when you ring them back, you're charged for the call, and it'll be somewhere in Belgium or Kazakhstan or somewhere. Yeah.
Well, I've been working with computers myself since 1981. And I would have to say that I was completely surprised the other day. I got an email from an old account from a service I used. It was actually a dating service, where they said, "Oh, thank you for changing your password." And I thought, well, that seems a bit odd. Maybe that's, I don't think I looked at that site recently, because I haven't really used it in like 4 years. And then I got another one saying, oh, thanks for your subscription. Well, I went onto the site, and this is a word of warning to everybody. I went onto the site, and I couldn't remember the password, but it has a link there. It says, I forgot my password. So they sent me an email with a link saying, you can now change your password. So I changed it to a really long, complicated password that I have a password manager, and it recorded that. So I knew that I was safe. Okay, it was like 16 characters long. Bunch of letters and numbers and things don't make any sense. I went on to the logged in. Sure enough, someone was using my identity and was scamming elderly women and was claiming that they were a widower for 6 years. And I saw some emails saying, oh, I won't give out my email to you on this site, but we can still chat. And I just closed the account. And it's frightening to think that somebody can just hack into something like that. And that's something that really a lot of seniors should be aware of. If, you know, you go to one of these Lonely Heart sites, and sometimes you can be scammed because they might lead you into a supposed relationship and then ask for money and send money.
Right. Yeah.
And people, unfortunately, get very trusting. And if you're not used to the internet, the internet is still like the Wild West in many ways.
That's careful. Right. And they have to, if you've got a new device, you've got to navigate that worry of that as well. We have an elder abuse response person called Anne, and she does support people and help them and those make them aware of the scams and discusses the safety around that. Yeah. And no doubt you would too when people come to see you.
Oh, absolutely.
Yeah, just... if you've got a feeling it's not right, it won't be right.
Well, yes. There was one person I helped. This is like a year ago, and then there were one at one of our learning hubs, and she came to me and said, "I think I made a mistake." I said, "What happened?" Well, I got an email saying I had to pay my Netflix account, but I thought I was on automatic payment, so they asked for my credit card number and all this stuff, and I went ahead and did that. And how much was the bill? Oh, sort of like $40. That's a lot of money. Yeah. I said, call your bank. Mm-hmm. Have that credit card put a hold on it or cancel it. They can give you a new number. Mm-hmm. They can give you a new card, but just put a hold on it. And wow. You know, so she became aware, but she tripped, but she was able to realize by coming to us and say, oh, is this a problem? And I was able to say, yes, it is. Mm-hmm. So be very, very careful. Anyway, we're going to take another short music break, and we'll be back in just a few minutes. But hold on, because help is on the way.
Harmony.
And we're back. And this is Let's Get Digital, the show brought to you by digital seniors here in the Wairarapa. Now, I'm here with Fran Reardon from Age Concern. Now, Fran, do you have some contact information for people who might be interested in getting some help?
I do. We're based actually in the Solway Showgrounds, Fleet Street entrance in Masterton. Our direct line, well, our main line in is 06-377-0066. Now that gets you into the main office. Now if you want to speak to me, I have my own number, which is 06-929-7569, and that will get you directly to my line. But if the other, both numbers are fine. I have an email address, which is avs@acww.nz. That's A for Apple, V for Vera, S for Sam, at A for Apple, C for Cat, www.nz. My colleague Anne Murrell, who's the social worker, she has a direct line, which is 06-929-7568, and she manages and supports people with any social work issues or advocacy issues or scam issues, those sorts of things, or any type of abuse. I also have a colleague in health promotion, and you can get her through the main number, which is 06-377-0066. There's also an elder abuse main line for New Zealand, which is a 24-hour number, and that number is 0800-32-66865. So it's 0800-32-66865. So that's a 24-hour number and then they get referred on those calls. We also have a magazine that we put out quarterly with lots of information on it. You can ring us if you want one of those magazines. And we've been sitting in the showgrounds. It's a really easy place to get to. There's lots of parking outside. Other services that we provide too in the Wairarapa, we do the total mobility assessments for people over 65. We do encourage people to get out and about, and so the mobility assessment allows you to get half-price taxis, the card. We help get them the card when you're not driving or unable to drive. We also have things called life tubes. Some of you already may know about those. It's a tube that you keep in your fridge, plastic canister, and you write all your personal information regarding contacts and about you, and there's a little red sticker inside the canister that goes on your fridge door. And the canister with all your information, it goes in the fridge. All the paramedics, civil defence, police, fire, they know about these canisters. And if they couldn't find you and they saw that on your fridge door, they'd pick it up and know that you lived there. So we give those out to people over 65 in the Wairarapa. So definitely, come and see us. We'd like to hear from you. If you're wanting to become an accredited visitor, by all means contact me. I always need volunteers, and like probably you do in your organisation too,
Roger. Absolutely. We need volunteers as well, because we're starting to get a bit more busy now.
Yep.
People are realising that they need to be able to figure out not only how their devices work, but in some cases, how do I contact family and friends? How do I use this thing called Zoom? How do I use this thing called Skype? And now that I mentioned Zoom, I'm just going to say that every Thursday morning at 11, we have a Zoom meeting, and any senior can come and talk to us on the Zoom chat. We usually get about four or five seniors there, and we have our coaches there. We do some fun things. We do some games. We have some challenges. We talk about various issues. We have people like yourself coming on as being guest speakers. And if you want to be able to do that, you can go on Facebook and look us up, Digital Seniors Learning. And if you don't have Facebook, you can always give us a call at 0800-373-646, and one of our people there will answer the phone, and they'll give you more information about how you can connect to us with Zoom once a week. So right now, I think what we're going to do is you're going to wrap it up, and I'm going to say thank you to Fran for coming along today and talking about Age Concern. And remember, we do this show every fortnight, and we're also on the website for Arrow FM. So please, if you want to catch up, you can listen to those shows on there. Okay, so bye for now.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.